super excited for today's video because this is a highly requested video. You guys want to know my thoughts and opinions on the Good and the Beautiful Language Arts Level 1. I did a look inside when, kind of like an unboxing and look inside when I first got this at the beginning of this school year. So I wasn't able to give like a review on it or my thoughts, but I just showed you guys all inside of it and things like that. And so now that we are almost halfway through the school year, I am very excited to share with you how it's been working for us and what we think of it. So you've heard me sing the praises of the Good and the Beautiful Language Arts before on my channel. So my daughter is in the first grade this year and we completed the level K last year and we absolutely loved it. They made some improvements. This is the newer edition and they made some improvements to the curriculum and we are thoroughly enjoying it. My daughter absolutely loves when it's time to do language arts. That's no exaggeration. My daughter loves it so much and oftentimes will complete multiple lessons in a day because she doesn't want to stop. She just wants to keep going. And that is just so good for me to see and such a relief to me. You know, as a homeschooling mom, I feel like we are kind of taking the road less traveled. We are doing the harder thing, you know, because the easier thing, I guess, would just be to send your kids to school and you wouldn't have to deal with this, you know, the schoolwork and things like that. Knowing that they're enjoying it and loving it is just so rewarding and makes me so happy. Last year, it wasn't quite so easy and she enjoyed it, but not like she does this year. And I heard Sarah McKenzie say of the Read Aloud Revival, if you haven't heard of her, she has a podcast and a website. And I heard her say that it's not uncommon that when in the beginning stages of when children are learning to read, that it's challenging for them. You know, they have to use their brain and they have to think really hard about, you know, what does that sound make? What is this when you combine it? You know, what is this, you know, to decode the words. That she said it's not uncommon for kids to not enjoy it because it's really difficult. So they're having to engage their brain and decode these words and it's challenging to read. And once it kind of clicks for them, is when it becomes fun. So last year when my daughter was in kindergarten, I was worried. I'm like, what am I doing wrong? Like, what if she doesn't enjoy reading? What if this, you know, I'm like ruining it for her or something because I'm like, you know, making her do this schoolwork. And she's kind of, you know, would get like a bad attitude about it or just kind of get upset. And so anyway, I've definitely seen what Sarah McKenzie is talking about, that once it clicks, and once it becomes easier for them, then they're really gonna start enjoying it. And so I've definitely experienced that this year with my first grader. I'm just gonna show you a quick lesson example here. So this is lesson 56. We're learning about common and proper nouns. So this has a little checkbox to practice the sight word letters, which are in the front of the book. And then this is the part, it just has it like read to the child. So you're gonna read all of this. And then, you know, it gives you instructions to write things on the board. Here's a little activity, have the child study the black and white picture on the next page. I love, as I mentioned, how it has the art just right in it. And then there's a little review chart in the back. It wants you to do the checkbox for personal or shared reading. And then this is the independent practice. So have the child fill in the blanks with the correct word, B or B. These are all things that they've gone over in previous lessons. And then again with two, two, or two. And that is the complete lesson. I don't really see us ever switching to a different language arts curriculum. I would worry that we were missing out on something in here. Like, I love everything that this combines. Find things like, you know, the art appreciation and the poetry, and there's even little activities and things in the lessons. There's actually like pages that they actually like paint and they're practicing. I don't know if you can see there. Practicing different painting skills, things like that. And it's all just right in the lesson. I love that there's not, you know, multiple components. They do have phonics cards as well as the level one reader that, you know, are companions for this curriculum. But most of it is just right in the lesson. So they work on the spelling words and, as I mentioned, the poetry, all those things right in the lesson. And each lesson now has an independent practice portion, which, I mean, it has been really good for us. Like, when we had the level K last year, I didn't realize how good it would be, so that the Level K did not have the independent practice in it, and it is so good to be able to complete, you know, my portion of the lesson with my daughter and say, okay, here's the independent practice, you know, go do this, and then after that we're going to do your 20 minutes of reading. Every lesson has a little personal or shared reading time. There's a little box that you check off once that's done to remind you and make sure that they're getting their reading time in. And then if they have to read a story in their level one reader, then that will be in place of their personal reading time. The art appreciation I mentioned is something that we really do enjoy. I feel like this is something that I would skip over it, but it might just not be as high up on my priority list when thinking about all the things that need to be done in the day and running a household with four children and all the things. I love that the art is a part of the lesson, so it doesn't get skipped over. My daughter's confidence has grown by leaps and bounds over the past few months that we've been doing this curriculum. She has really loved reading. I find her in her room reading books, things like that, and I just feel like a curriculum that really fosters that sort of love of reading and gives them the confidence that they need and just a firm foundation for a lifetime of reading, I feel like is just a curriculum that does all of that is just number one in my book. And so that's why I just don't see myself ever leaving. I don't see myself ever switching. I love it, and I'm really excited for my boys to start using the Level K. I think they're really going to enjoy it as well when they're ready for that. So I hope you enjoyed hearing my thoughts on the Good and the Beautiful Level 1 curriculum. Now that we are a little less than halfway through it, you guys have been asking my thoughts on it and how it's going, so I wanted to share with you. So thanks for watching the video today. If you enjoyed it, I would love it if you'd give it a thumbs up and leave me a comment down below and let me know, are you doing the Good and the Beautiful? Have you been enjoying it as much as we have been? I would love to know. I love talking to you guys in the comments and going, just hearing about you guys and what you're doing and your thoughts on things and stuff. I respond to every single one and I love getting every single one. Again, thanks for watching today's video, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.